Hey guys, I'm out here on one now. Guy actually called me about just checking it out. They had it installed, of course, by a professional that's been doing it for 20 years. Just got on his own. So anyway, just show you what the kind of stuff we run into. Anyway, I didn't want to come behind it, but it just is what it is. It was installed yesterday, and then now it's wasn't blowing good heat, and he didn't think it was working right. So what I did was I just come out here, and then first thing, let me just show you what we got. This is the heat pump. It's a 2-ton system, and I'll show you what I'm finding. Sitting directly on the ground, no rubber boots on it. They come with rubber boots. And this is a, I think it's 2021-22 Sears, so it's a high efficiency model. The line set would just had tape on it. It's bent pretty good here, so I'm not sure whether we got a kink or something here, but I'm gonna go back and check these fittings. But if I'm just reading the pressures on it, I'm reading right at 400 pounds. Well, the problem with reading pressures on one of these is, now we'll go in here so you can hear me a little better, is the blower speeds up and slows down according to what the compressor is. So what you're going to have is the pressures are going to look fine, but the blower slowed down. So anyway, I'm going to show you how to fix this thing right. All right, so it really didn't have no gas in it. The guy just left. So anyway, all right, right here on the data plate. I'll look on the data plate, you find the refrigerant. It's 82.9 ounces. And I'm just going to weigh it in. That's the easiest thing to do. Got your gauges set up. Got my scale set up. Do this with one hand here, and here's the happy homeowner. We're paying the professional, and let's see, now we're gonna zero it out. All right guys, so what I did is we got our jug set on here, set my scale to zero, and then on the side of the machine it said 82.6 ounces, and I just got it just going in. I opened up this side and allowing it to go in and watching it go in. Now, in the heating mode, the only way you can do it is put it in forced cooling, because the temperature ain't gonna drop enough to do it. And then of course he left the caps off too, and I'm gonna fix that. So this is the best way to do it. If you low in gas, do it by weight. There is no guess whether it's right or whether it's wrong, but find out why it's low in gas. And I got a feeling that he cracked the valves before he had it fixed and didn't have any gas to put in it. So we're getting there. It's on 20, so ain't nowhere close. But again, force cooling mode, see, it's on FC. Force cooling is you come in here and mash this twice. The first time you mash it, puts it in automatic. And that sets the heating and cooling at a default temperature around 70 degrees. And mash it twice, puts it in force cooling. And I'll turn it back on once we get it gassed up. All right, we're getting real close. So I'm gonna meter this thing in, 78. And it's gonna come, get back 82. I'm gonna shut it down right there. And then we're gonna let it run for a bit. See how it does.